In the year 2020 alone, big pharma, pharmaceutical companies here in the United States, donated $13.7 million in direct donations to members of the U.S. House and U.S. Senate. $7.1 million of that went to Republicans, $6.6 million of that went to the Democrats. So Republicans have a slight edge, but that's, you know, pretty close to a 50-50 split here. Where'd the money go? The money went to 72 members of Congress who cashed checks from the drug industry in 2020 and 302 members of the U.S. House of Representatives who cashed checks from the drug industry in 2020. So what we're looking at here is the fact that two-thirds of Congress has money from drug companies sitting in their campaign coffers. And again, all of this happened during a pandemic, during a time when healthcare was on everybody's brains, not just because of the pandemic either, but because we were in the middle of a contentious presidential race where the issue of universal healthcare was gaining steam for a while. Majority of people in this country supported a Medicare for all healthcare plan, and drug companies understood that their profit party could be coming to an end if something like that were to happen, or if you got enough progressives in Congress to push for drug pricing reform. And they had to stop that. But they also had to stop anyone from not letting them get patents on the vaccines they were developing. So it was a two-pronged approach. We don't want universal health care or caps on our drug prices. And we also want to be able to make a ton of money off these vaccines patents. So let's pay off as many members of Congress as humanly possible. And two-thirds of members of Congress, Senate and House, said right here, I'd like some of that money. We can never move forward as a country. We can never move forward with policies that actually benefit the American public as long as things like this continue to happen. That money, $13.7 million, was enough to pay off just enough people to prevent meaningful action on any of those three issues I mentioned. Medicare for all right now, with the current state of Washington, D.C., is dead. And it sucks to say that, but let's accept that reality. For now, it is dead. Biden's not going to do it. We're probably not even going to get a public option where we could pay the government for health insurance, which is still not good, but we're not even going to get that. Drug pricing, there's been some legislation here and there, hasn't gone anywhere, so that's kind of still floating, but not actionable. And then, of course, vaccine patents. No, instead, what we're going to do is we're going to buy doses from these major drug companies that we already paid to develop the vaccines. We're going to buy hundreds of millions of doses from them to send to other countries instead of waiving the waivers so the countries can make their own at a smaller price. No, we got to make sure the drug companies get their money, right? And if they can't get it from the poor countries, don't worry, we'll spot you. The drug industry's got it made in the shade, folks. They have paid off enough people. They have spread that money evenly around Democrats, Republicans. Almost everybody's on the dole. And until we get rid of corporate money and corporate influence like this, nothing will ever change. Thanks for watching. And if you like what you saw, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel for fresh content every single day of the week. Just smash that subscribe button. And of course, don't forget to like, comment, and share the video.